Sound is caused by movement and vibration. The pitch is how high or how low the pitch is. Pitch is measured by a unit called a hertz. For example, an A that vibrates at 440 hertz will be caused by sound waves that vibrate 440 times a second. It sounds like this. In 1926, the American music industry reached an informal standard of A440 Hertz. In 1955, the International Organization for Standardization finalized the tuning to remain at 440A. In researching the history of pitch and tuning, I found out it has not always been 440A. I hope the facts I present today will show the significance of tuning and the connection between outer space and our inner lives. Here's a part of a famous Mozart song tuned at 440A Hertz. Now what if we change the tuning to A293? It's going to sound like this. Obviously, it sounds a lot different. So what happened to tuning before 1926? What is happening now, and how does it affect us? Let's start with the Baroque music of the 1600s and 1700s, when Bach and Handel and Vivaldi were writing immortal works like the Magnificat, the Hallelujah Chorus in Messiah, and the Vivaldi Four Seasons. The tuning we hear today, 440, which I played before, and here's an A, by the way, if you're not a musician, it's pitched higher than the original tunings at that time, which was 415. And in musical notation, you can see it's quite different. For you musicians out there, our G sharp was their A. So listen to the difference between the G sharp and the A. That's 415, and here's 440. Many orchestras are tuning it even higher. A few weeks ago, I traveled to China with the South Shore Orchestra based in Chicago. One cultural exchange was playing a concert with some music students. Their orchestra was pitched to 444. Here are some historical facts about pitch and tuning. Antique tuning forks were used by Mozart and Beethoven, were tuned about 421, slightly higher than the Baroque 415. In 1885, the Australian government recognized 435 to be established as the standard. In 1989, over a dozen opera superstars, including Luciano Pavarotti, added their names to a petition to the Italian government to lower the standard tuning to 432. There were many reasons, including the pending extinction of the color of the mezzo-soprano voice. Sadly, the petition failed. There'll be some day where we will never hear an authentic mezzo-soprano sound. Personally, I'm also drawn to the 432A. Before I knew about tuning, I recorded my compositions inside the Great Pyramid in Egypt. Everything sounded best at 432A, so I blended in with 440 using my voice on 440, sometimes simultaneously. Tom Spahn, the sound engineer who mastered this album, noticed all of this. And he nicknamed me the Pitch Bitch. It's okay. He wants to call me that, that's fine. My piano teacher, William Browning, was a student of Carl Friedberg, who was a student of Clara Schumann, who worked very closely with Johannes Brahms. Brahms' final compositions were also pitched at 432. Here here's some historical and outer space facts that blew my mind, and also some theories worth serious consideration. Brendan D. Murphy writes in Waking Times that ancient Egyptian and Greek musicians tuned at 432, and the dimensions of the Great Pyramid in Egypt contained 432. The diameter of the sun is 432 times 2,000 miles. The diameter of the moon is 432 times 5 miles. Rudolf Steiner, founder of the Waldorf School, stated, "Music based at 432 hertz will support humanity and its way towards spiritual freedom." Maria Reynolds, in her book called Intervals, Scales, Tones, and the Concert Pitch, claims evidence that a 440 tuning disassociates the connection of consciousness to the body and creates antisocial conditions in humanity. Len Horowitz, MDM and MPH, Master of Public Health, writes for Medical Veritas, the Journal of Truth and Health Science. Even the title of his article is provocative. Listen to this. Musical Cult Control: The Rockefeller Foundation's War on Consciousness Through the Imposition of a 440 Hertz Standard Tuning. Interesting read if you want to get into it. Since ancient times, the moon, associated with passion, intensity, and emotional events, like the Passover of the Jews, the Holy Festival in India, and even Easter, was scheduled by the moon. Since Pythagoras and Plato, scientists and engineers of the modern age have been working out theories and calculations of the planets. And you can see what I've drawn here on the board. The 415 is a lower pitch than, say, the 440. Here's where I heard it in China. It gets higher and higher. I especially resonate with the discovery that the orbit of the moon around the Earth oscillates at the pitch of G sharp, the same pitch tuned during the Baroque era. Think of the magnitude of this fact. Why did the immortal music masters compose with tuning G sharp, or close, which is close to the 432, rather than today's 440 and higher? My answer is they pulled it right out of the sky